My sister Maddie is my best friend, and ever since we were younger, she's always been very humorous and fun and absolutely the sweetest person that I've ever met. Well, I was usually described as harsh and sassy, but although we were considered opposites, we got along really well together. But my sophomore year, my sister turned into a hollow of a person I didn't recognize anymore. Her eighth grade year, she started coming down with symptoms resembling those of mono, and she would go to the doctors twice a week and get tested for different illnesses, and they would always come back negative. And I'm not sure if it was jealousy that she got to stay home from school for 2 weeks or just a sisterly intuition, but I wasn't convinced that she was physically ill. And I know that sounds crazy, but in a weird way, I was right. She confided in me during that time that she believed she had depression, and I brushed it off and figured she was just vying for attention. But my sister went back to the doctors a couple days later, and they diagnosed her with clinical depression. Everything following that is just a blur. I remember my mom coming into my room telling me to hide my razors, and she was just crying. I had my 15th birthday, and the next thing I know, I came home to find my sister didn't live with me anymore, and she'd been moved to a behavioral health center called Fairfax, about an hour from our house. Eventually, my doubt in her depression subsided, and my sister returned over the summer almost a different person. She was more religious, she dressed more modestly, and she would chide me for wearing a bikini. And though I thought it was weird, I was still super happy that she was home and was thrilled to be starting high school with her at Ever High. But the beginning of her freshman year and my junior year quickly became the worst time of my life. She would go to school and be super bubbly and friendly with everyone and seem totally normal, and then come home and be quiet and numb and isolate herself from me and my parents. She would go home and cut herself and hide the wounds at school. She would sit in class and visualize hanging herself, and a couple of times she had to talk herself out of jumping out of the third story girls' bathroom window in this building. One day when I was driving her home from school, she walked into our house after she got out of the car, and I followed a couple minutes later to find her shove a handful of pills into her mouth. And I screamed at her to spit them out, and when she didn't, I became livid, and I ran over to her and pried her mouth open and shoved the pills out myself. And after that, my sister couldn't even be alone for 2 minutes without attempting suicide or trying to cut herself. It got to the point where me and my parents had to take turns coming home from school to take care of her and watch her. And I know that this sounds really selfish, but I was starting to hate my sister. I hated the constant fear of walking in on her dead body. I hated seeing my mom scream at the receptionist on the other end of the phone when she told her there weren't any rooms available at any treatment center, and my sister just sat there and laughed. And I hated that something that I couldn't see or comprehend was ruining my family's lives, and we were just drowning in fear and worry. My sister was eventually admitted back into Fairfax while she waited to be moved to a long-term mental health center specifically for youth in Spokane. But when spots weren't opening up, my parents considered sending her out of state, but even those places were filled to the brim. So out of desperate need for constant care, my sister was moved to Texas to live with my grandparents, and she had a team of therapists and psychologists, but was still experiencing suicidal ideations and hallucinations. After 6 months, she started showing some progress and returned home, but with her came back my fear and worries that I was experiencing before. And just as they were starting to subside, my fears became a reality when I was hanging out with my best friend downstairs, and my sister walked down, silently crying, and her forearms just spilling out blood. And my parents drove her to the ER, and I didn't see her again for 8 months. Eventually, my sister was admitted to the long-term care facility in Spokane, which in itself was a miracle. It's one of the four in the state that are specifically meant for youth, and each one only has about 15 beds each. That's about 60 beds available for the staggering amount of children diagnosed with severe depression. Just in our area alone, there's about 700,000 people diagnosed with severe depression and about 4 million in the state. And that's only counting severe depression. That's not counting any other mental illness. And this number is increasing every year, along with the amount of deaths by suicide per year. Despite this rise, there's not a corresponding increase in the amount of treatment provided for these people. If more tax dollars and government funding was directed to the building of mental health care facilities, then people could get the care that they desperately need. And not only that, but there would be more job opportunities available. The homeless population could decrease, and the amount of prison inmates would lessen because about 60% of them are diagnosed with a mental illness. And on top of it all, the deaths by suicide per year could decrease significantly. My sister's been in treatment for about 2 years, and she's about to be released, and I've seen noticeable positive change in her, and that funny, sweet girl that I grew up with is finally recognizable again. I'm blessed to say that my family got to celebrate her 16th birthday this month, which is something I feared we wouldn't be able to do, and my mom was so thrilled about it. She made her this chocolate cake and threw a surprise party before she had to go back to her facility. And through it all, my relationship with my sister has become so much stronger. She's gained incredible insight and wisdom, and now I'm going to her for advice when I'm the older sister. I would do absolutely anything for her, and I'll never stop trying to shed light on the dark issue of depression and suicide. Everyone is worthy of life and help and care, and no one should have to lose their best friend or loved one. No one should be forced to face an illness on their own, and no one should have to lose their family member over lack of professional care. Even when everything around you is crumbling and falling apart, and it seems like it will never get better, that doesn't mean that it's permanent and that happiness is unattainable. With the willingness to help others, the want to receive that help, and the personal desire to heal when broken, it's possible to overcome the worst and the darkest days, and my beautiful, brave sister is the perfect example of that.